So, okay, Sahej ji, Chandan ji, all did not do warm-up exercises. So, no problem. We will do some warm-up before we start. And yes, I want to tell you, yoga is very, very important for RA. In fact, I feel it is more important than that of diet as well. And I, in between, actually, when my RA improved and my blood report improved, so I took my... I was completely feeling so good, and I took this yoga sessions for granted, and I was continuously working. I thought that now I'm completely fine. What is the use? Why do I need yoga? But when I skipped yoga, then I felt that symptoms returned. So that is the reason yoga is something that you have to do for entire lifetime. So because that you have got this disease, let this disease be, like you can say, guiding angel. This disease is a guiding angel because whenever you skip any healthy routine, it will give a symptom or alarm in the form of joint pain. So this is not like a disease. Actually, don't look at it like a disease. This RA is like a good friend of you, and whenever you will ignore this disease and go back to old way, the symptoms will return. So that is the reason diet and yoga is something that you have to do forever. Many people ask me this question recently, like, can I stop this diet and this lifestyle after I get well? The answer is no. You have to do it forever till the last breath. So that is the reason you have to enjoy, because this life is been given by God to enjoy. So we are all here to enjoy this sattvic journey together, exercise together, and have this awesome diet together. So if you all are ready to enjoy the session, type enjoy in the comment box. Okay, so we will do some yoga. And before that, today I learned this concept of being detached observer. I wanted to share that also. Like, when you detached observer means what? It is like you just like watching the movie, right? When you watch a movie, you a hero, villain, there is hero, villain, heroine, okay? So you are detached from the movie. So that is the reason you are able to enjoy the movie, right? But and our life is also just like a movie. Our life is also a story. It has a beginning, it has an end. When we are born, it is beginning. When we die, it is end. So it is a big movie. So when you watch your story as a movie, that is when you become detached also, like a witness. So don't think that this rheumatoid disease happened to you. Think that this disease happened to a character. So now I am a character, Seema. So Seema character got disease. You are a soul which is like infinite. So this character got the disease. So that will help you to become detached. And when you become detached, you will be more efficient and present in the moment. So look at it like, just separate yourself outside. Just they show in some movies, know how soul comes out of the body and they can see themselves, right? Something like that. So it's weird, but yes, you can practice that, and that will be detached observer, and you will be able to see yourself, and that will give you more stability, more stillness, more calmness. Okay. And while doing yoga, your thoughts should not run very fast. It should be still. That is when your pose will also be still. You will be able to hold positions for longer, and that is when you will get more results also. Okay. So if you all understood this concept of detached observer, type yes in the comment box. Type yes. Okay. Suhasini, Chandan ji, you all are here to enjoy. Ankita ji is asking about weight gain. Why we are not gaining weight? Ankita ji, do share it in the Google form. Yes, I will share it. Gaining weight is difficult because our intestine is, the toxins are still accumulated in the intestine. Our body is not able to absorb the required nutrition. So that is the reason we need to detox our body first, remove all the toxins out, And it is a process. Once you are healed, slowly you will also gain weight. So don't worry at all. Future is very beautiful, bright. You will be perfectly healthy, healthy weight. Everything will be fine. Awesome. Chandan ji, Shahid ji, Pravita ji, Ranganathan ji, you all have understood this concept of detached observer. Okay, so now let's start doing some yoga. Okay, so I will show you the yoga positions. As soon as I wake up, okay, I do some warm-up exercises, and that smiling routine is always, it is always there. I never miss that. As soon as I wake up, I smile. Good morning to Almighty, good morning to self, then charging water. All this is there. And in between, I also do some warm-up stretching. Then after water and all daily routines, I do some exercises on bed itself. Because many people face morning stiffness, so it might be difficult to get yoga mat. Then on yoga mat, they might feel lazy. So directly on bed, which exercises you can do lying down. Today, we will see those asanas, okay? And you have to do those asanas according to your capacity. Don't push yourself, enjoy. Do the best you can, okay? So here I wake up, okay? And directly which you can start. So we will start with some gentle exercise. I want all of you to turn on your cameras, and you all also have to get into action mode, okay? So we are all family, don't shy from the camera. We all have to be bindas, because this life is a story, right? And we all are creators here. So whenever you're not able to hear me, just ping, okay? So we will start. I want all of you to do it along with me, okay? I will check everyone's video in between. So most of them have not turned on their camera. I want everyone to turn on their camera so that all can see your action mode, okay? So that is how you can inspire, you know, that is golden triangle formula. Because when you share and inspire others with your actions, you also get benefit. You get blessings from others. And blessings are more powerful than medicines. Okay. So this is my Bluetooth speaker here. Hope that you all are able to hear me. Okay. So first, start with your toes. From here, like that, we move up and till the neck. Okay. So warm up starts from the toes always. So five. Toes, you have to move forward and backward. And when you have more time, hold for longer position, longer time. So stretch and hold. Five comes. One, two, three, four, five. Then inwards and hold. One, two, three, four, five. Do this five times, okay? And you'll see after some days, now you'll even sweat. When you do for 10, 15 counts, those joints will start sweating. That means toxins are coming out. So continue that, doing that very gently, because when you wake up in the morning, there will be morning stiffness. Okay. So after doing this five counts, then you can do rotations. So this is what I do every day. Okay. This is what I do every day. Do rotations. Continue doing rotations. I'll keep on checking if all of you are doing, okay? So do this rotations. Yes, I can see someone is doing it, because it inspires me also to take action and continue such sessions. Okay? So after this ankle rotations, clockwise and anti-clockwise, okay? Both ways, five counts. So this number five is easy. It is not too much also, not too less. So it is perfect. Then comes knees. Then you can compress the knees. Compress, release. Compress, release. Compress, release. Five times. So now we are short of time, so we are doing it fast. But when you're having a lot of time, then you have to do it with a lot of patience. You can do it extend for 2 hours. So now knees is done. Now we will move for hips. So the best one is butterfly. this so I enjoy this session. I enjoy this butterfly exercise. I do it for like sometimes 5 minutes also, like listening to some podcast. So when I'm watching any video or some movie, I never sit idle. I always do it with some movement, some butterfly, then rotations. So this is what you can do, okay? So the next, you know, if someone is having this ankle joint pain, then you can fold this leg like that, okay? And this is also one asana warm up. So you have to press like that. Up, then press down. Up and down. So 5 counts. Okay. Then what you can do is if your ankle joint is very stiff, then you can hold it with your hand and rotate it. Suppose if you are not able to rotate with your by yourself, so you can rotate with your hand. Now we will do only 3 counts so that we can make best use of time. Then same with other leg. Up, then press down. Up, then press down. Up, then press down. Then with your hands, you can rotate the ankle. Suppose if it is difficult for you and you have ankle joint pain, then that time you can do this. Then other is you can do some like that stretching, matlab cycling. So you'll feel very good stretch near your ankle joint, knee joint. So we are doing 3 counts, okay, now. Now other leg. So first right leg, then left leg. 3 counts like that. Then 3 counts like that. Opposite side. So I'm not trained. I would like to keep a disclaimer. So you can just learn by watching me. So this was off leg. The next what I do is this asana. This I learned from Ramdev Baba actually. So credit goes to him as well. You can also check out his videos on YouTube. See like that. So what he calls is chakki pisne ka asana. So in olden days, women used to do this chakki, you know. So they were so healthy, right? So 5 times clockwise, 5 times anti-clockwise. Okay. I'm actually sweating now. My legs are sweating. So simple exercise. If you do it daily, so much you will, it is like a medicine, you know, slowly over a period of time, your medicines will reduce. Now you can open your legs wide open and stretch your hand, then touch opposite leg toe with your left hand. Touch your right toe and with your right hand touch left toe. This also I enjoy. Sometimes I do it up to 40 counts, 50 counts. And most important is breathing. Breathe with every moment. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Or you can do it even slowly. Okay, after this, we will do shoulder rolls. Now we will do little quickly so that I can show you more asanas. 3 time clockwise, 3 time anti-clockwise, then elbows, 3 times like that, then rotations. Okay. Clockwise, anti-clockwise, your finger joints, stretch your finger joints, rotate your wrist. This I have shown in earlier session of Yogathon. Okay, so we from toes, we are moving upwards. Now do neck roll, neck rotations. 3 times clockwise and 3 times anti-clockwise. Okay, so now we have completed our warm up. So this is like first level of warm up. I will show you other level of warm up as well. Maybe I'll create some YouTube video someday. So this is now we will so this is very important to do before asana. Never directly move to asana, because I tried doing that and you sometimes you get sprained suddenly. So we don't want all those things, right? So what if you have, I had ankle joint deformity. So I always take this help of such cushion before I do Vajrasana, okay? So if you're not able to do it, you can do with Sukhasana also, like that sitting position, okay? So what I do, I take help of this cushion and I do Vajrasana like that. So slowly you can do like that. So this is very good for knees. Okay. This is also called Mandukasana. And then you put fist, exhale, then move like that downwards. So blood rushes to your brain. Then you can come up. So the second position is stretch your hand up, then do like that. Breathing is very important. Then up, point up. Slowly take your hands down, then come back to original position. So I enjoy this also very much. This Vajrasana you can do even after you had food. So it is very good for digestive system. And always remember, after you have food, always remember to sit erect, okay? Spinal cord. Never slouch. Because your digestive system, the food needs to pass properly. So always keep your spine erect whenever you eat food, after eating food. Then next, that exercise that you can do lying down is, okay, let me see if you all are doing it along with me. Are all of you doing? Then just tell okay in the video. Are all of you doing it? Yes, okay, Kavita ji is doing it, awesome. Others I think are just watching, maybe they will do it later. Okay, Ravi ji is also doing it. Awesome, Suhasini ji. Okay, hope you all will do it later after watching it. Okay, so I'll show you other videos now. Other asana, okay? Other asana that I do lying down is this. Let me read some comments. Okay, Chandan ji, Sonali ji, all are typing yes. Okay, all are doing it, that means. Awesome, thank you so much for all your support. So next exercise, this is very, very easy, okay? You'll enjoy this. I do it every day. So this, lie on your stomach. Keep your hands like that. And do it this way. Okay? So your hamstring muscles will stretch. It is very, very good for hamstrings. So slowly, first you can do one leg. Then slowly you can do two legs. Initially, you can do three counts, then you can do five counts also. Okay. Then the next asana that I do in the same position is, Shalabhasana. You can also call it Superman. So you have to raise your legs and raise your hands like that. I call it Superman asana. You feel like Superman flying in the sky. So breathing is very, very important. Then after doing such asana, relax. Relax for 15 seconds. Just breathe. Relaxation is very important for asana. Between asana, or else it will stress or it may increase your stress hormone. So we need to enjoy yoga.
my relaxing in between.
Then the next position of Shalabhasana is you hold your hands behind. Okay, then you pull, you hold your wrist and you again raise your legs and pull your hands and stretch your ankle joints. You'll feel that pressure, that stretch in ankle joints. So very good for ankle also and neck, thyroid. Inhale when up, hold for your best capacity. 5 seconds to 15 seconds, then relax. Then next asana is you keep your hands below your thighs, then raise one leg above. Raise, hold for some time, release. Raise, hold for some time, release. Then you can even raise both your legs. Then relax. All this asana will take time, but it is worth it. Then next is Bhujangasana. So many asana you can do on bed right away. You don't need to get down also. So keep your hands side of the elbow, inhale and raise upward. Very good for spine. Then relax. So if you have trouble in wrist joint, then you can avoid this.
Never pressurize because the inflammation will increase. If any of your joint is hurting,
then you can skip that asana and do just stretching. Then other asana is Dhanurasana, you know. This you hold your ankle joints and raise upwards. Actually, this is best done in mat. So this is better to avoid on bed. So this I'm just showing when I'm on mat, I do this exercise. And better to do it empty stomach early in the morning, actually. Then you can lie on your back. So this was prone position or lying on stomach exercise. Now I'll show you the exercises that you can do lying on the back. I hope that all are able to hear me. Okay. So this you can do. You have to fold your one leg and try to touch your chin to that knee. It's also part of Pavan Mukta Asana. Then I did right leg, now left leg. Fold it like that. Then try to touch your chin. And breathe. Then both legs. My fingers are actually sweating now. So then after this, what I do now, I'm sharing fast, but I take a lot of rest because still few minutes remaining. But you can do with lot of breaks, okay? Then I do this leg raise. Stretch upwards. and you'll feel like ankle joint stretching and blood rushing through your body. Very good. You can do this for 5 counts. So easily you can do it on bed. And do it every day actually to see results. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. So keep the sequence in mind, okay? It is very easy. Then I do rotations. I started enjoying this so much that I feel like doing every time. Actually, I did this morning also. This is second time I'm doing now. Then clockwise and then anti-clockwise. 5 counts. Then do it with other leg as well. This is very good for hip joint, you know. Hip joint is so precious. One of the biggest joint in our body. And it is our responsibility to take care. Inhale, exhale. Yoga is incomplete without breath. So make sure you take deep breath every time. I hope that you're counting correctly, 5 counts, because I may miss. Okay. So this session is showing, time is running out. So after this, you can do both legs. So there is a pop-up. Just give me 1 second. I want everyone to do it, okay, along with me. This session will end in next 10 minutes, okay? So we'll close the session in some time. So this is last we'll do. See, my reminder is, this is my alarm actually. It reminds me to get up and stretch. So I want all of you to keep reminders like that in mobile. So relax. Then I do with both legs. Or cycling, I do both legs. So you can start with 3 counts. Then 3 count clockwise. Then relax. Then do this cycling. See, you're working out all your joints. Clockwise, anti-clockwise. Stretch, stretch. Then relax. This can be a bit tiring, but relax. Then finally, I end with Markatasana. So you stretch your hands sideways and keep your knees on ankle joint. So you twist like that. Your head, your drishti should be on left and your legs are bent on the, no, your drishti on the right and legs are bent to the left. Then same opposite side. This is called Markatasana. And the other position is both the legs are joined and you twist it. So when you're twisting, your knees is bent towards left, you will look at right, towards right. Then same opposite side. And then last, asana of Markatasana is stretch and touch opposite end. So left leg I'm touching, right leg I'm touching to the left hand. So same with other side. Left leg I'm touching towards right hand. and you look towards the left. So here I complete my daily asana and I do it more slow, so it takes up to 1 hour. Then I rest, deep rest for a few minutes. Imagine that you're floating on clouds, on the sky. Feel light. Be detached observer. Listen to the stillness around you in the atmosphere. Listen to the sound of silence. Breathe. Experience all the muscles, tissues loosened up and relaxed. Blood flowing more fast across the body. And every organ, tissue, cell is thanking you for taking care of themselves. Just visualize them smiling and telling you thank you, so that it will motivate you to do again tomorrow. So now you can get up and sit back again. So after this, I do short pranayam. So we will just do anulom vilom and some om, then we will end this session. So inhale from left. Hold for 2 counts. Exhale from right. Inhale. Hold for 2 counts. Exhale. Then one more cycle we'll do. Inhale. Hold for 2 counts. Exhale. Inhale. Hold for 2 counts. Exhale. Then I end with reciting Om. So how you recite Om? First inhale deep. So with along with exhalation, you tell this Om. Then it will be very smooth. Inhale. Along with exhalation, tell Om. Om. Inhale. With exhalation, the longer the better. So yes, we here we end this yogathon. So how many of you is feeling awesome, type awesome in the comment box? Nishaj is telling video is not visible. Just check your internet connection. Oh, Pravita ji is feeling awesome, energetic. Chandan ji is feeling awesome. Arav ji is feeling awesome. So nice to see. So we want to maintain this feeling awesomeness. It should not be full one day, okay? Our whole life needs to be awesome. So if whole life needs to be awesome, your each day counts. Every day is like a break of your whole life. So only when you do it every day by choice, you will get result. And you will forget ki RA hai ki nahi hai. You'll forget that you have this disease, rheumatoid. So enjoy the journey, enjoy the process, and the result will happen by product. And I want you to do pranayam also for a long time. So now this session will end in 1 minute. So I was not able to show pranayam. So do Kapalbhati pranayam and Anilom Vilom. I refer to this Ramdev Baba videos also. So Google search Ramdev Baba yoga videos, Ramdev Baba pranayam, or any other yoga teacher you can follow. Everyone are doing their best and 100%. So there's so much to learn. But we need to choose whom we are following. Follow right people and your life will be beautiful. But do it. That is the more important. Ranganathan ji telling Seema ji your intention to keep everybody happy, great service. Thank you so much. That when you share your happiness, wo bolte na, gyan baatne se badhta hai. So happiness also, when you share, you grow. So it is mutual always. Thank you so much, Ravi ji, Arav ji.
Madam,
so yes, we will share all the questions I'll share on YouTube, okay? So now this session will end. Thank you so much. Love you all. Bye-bye. Take care and keep doing this exercise every day. Bye-bye, everyone. And do share your feedback inside the WhatsApp group and Hub group if you're already inside my inner circle. So that we inspire everyone to watch the recording and practice this yoga sessions at home. Bye-bye, everyone. Happy weekend. Happy Sunday.